The atmosphere is changing now. For the Spirit of the Lord.
Hello, welcome to the Spirit of Lent. My name is Reverend Father Christopher Namani. I want to speak about fasting according to Catholic tradition. Fasting is the reduction of the amount of food intake we usually have during the day. That's how Catholics see it. It's related to abstinence, whereas fasting is the reduction in the amount of food that we take. Abstinence is the avoidance of certain things that are good in themselves, but we avoid them for the sake of a more spiritual good. For example, avoidance of meat or drink. Fasting, according to Catholic tradition, is very necessary because it helps to uplift our spirit. It helps us to reflect and also to live interior life. Fasting is meaningful if it goes with prayer and almsgiving, if it goes with avoidance of sin, evil desire, evil thought, useless talks, and evil association. According to Catholic tradition, it does not make sense that we fast for the sake of fasting. There would always be an aim for which we fast. Jesus himself told us how we must fast, and Catholic Church follows that teaching. That when we fast, we should anoint our faces. We should not display it to people to know that we are fasting. So it's something that is done in secret so that our Father, who sees all that is done in secret, will reward us. So fasting and also living life of sin cannot go together. Fasting would always go with righteous life, life of prayer, almsgiving, and also life of justice. If we fast, we should also remember those who are suffering. In Catholic Church, we fast during Lent, especially on Ash Wednesday and Good Friday. But whatever we collect from our fasting, we use it to do charity to the poor, to help those who are in need, which means that our fasting is not just to punish the body, but also to help other people who are in need. So fasting goes with charity and justice. So I encourage you to see fasting as a spiritual exercise that will help you to come closer to God and also to one another, to be close to God and to be close to your neighbor. And if you do this, Jesus himself that fasted would bless you. And so I encourage you and pray that this Lenten period will be a period of renewal and spiritual upliftment for you. And so I bless you. May Almighty God, who gave us his Son Jesus Christ to suffer for us, who fasted and liberated us from sin and death, bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.